morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I am well, and I hope you are all well as well. I want to start by letting you know what an incredible joy it is to be able to come together in this way, especially with all of you and with all of you folks at home. We're gonna go ahead and get started. We're gonna start the way I like to start most things in my life, and that is with prayer. Oh God, our guide and guardian, you have led us apart from the busy world into the quiet of this, your house. Grant us grace to worship you in spirit and in truth, to the comfort of our souls and the upbuilding of every good purpose and holy desire. Enable us to do more perfectly the work to which you have called us, that we may not fear the coming of night, when we shall resign into your hand the tasks which you have committed to us. So may we worship you with our lips and our souls at this hour. Excuse me. So may we worship you not with our lips at this hour, but in word and deed all the days of our lives. Through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. And now with the confidence of children of God, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Let's pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Our hymn of preparation today is Jesus, Lover of My Soul.
Thank you.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 14, verses 22 through 33. Immediately he made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he dismissed the crowds, he went up the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But by this time the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early in the morning, he came walking toward them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost!" And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." And Jesus said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat, started walking on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." This is the word of God for the children of God.
Thanks be to God.
When I was researching today's scripture reading, I found in my new interpreter's Bible, thank you to Jim and Jean Rencounter, by the way, for donating this entire set. But I was looking through my new interpreter's Bible and I found something in the reflection section about this passage that I cannot put it into better words. The typical lesson derived from this text often borders on the demonic misunderstanding the nature of faith, which Matthew wants to warn us against. The message is not, if he had had enough faith, he could have walked on water. Just as the message to us is not, if we had enough faith, we could overcome all our problems in spectacular ways. This interpretation is wrong in that it identifies faith with spectacular exceptions to the warp and woof of our ordinary days, days that are all subject to the laws of physics and biology. This is wrong because when our fantasies of overcoming this web are shattered by the realities of accident, disease, aging, and circumstance, and we begin to sink, this view encourages us to feel guilty because of our lack of faith. Now this is the part that really, really speaks to me. What if the message of this text were, if he had enough faith, he would have believed the word of Jesus that came to him in the boat as mediating the presence and reality of God? So is Jesus talking to Peter about sinking because of lack of faith? Or is Jesus talking to Peter about his lack of faith and asking Jesus, if it's really you, call me out onto the water? In his interpretation, Eugene Peterson, in his interpretation of Matthew's Gospel, in his interpretation of the Bible called The Message, he says, Jesus says, "Faint of heart, what got into you? What made you decide to question me? So that I needed to call you out of the boat." So is the questions of Peter faith about sinking in the water? We're going to talk about that in just a moment. But I think it's very critical for Peter and for us to realize that it wasn't his lack of faith that kept him from walking on the water. It was his lack of faith that made him question Jesus to begin with. I find that to be very, very interesting. So few times do we look back at the thing that made him get out of the boat to begin with. But now we aren't going to talk about getting out of the boat. Peter gets out of the boat, and he's walking toward Jesus. And all of a sudden, he looks down at the waves, and the wind blows against him. And what happens to him? He gets scared, right? And once he gets scared, he starts to sink. So we are to conclude that it was his faith in Jesus that made it so he could walk on the water to begin with. But when he started to get scared, his faith disappeared, and he started to sink. What does he do when he starts to sink? What's the first thing that Peter does when he starts to sink? Have you ever heard the expression that there are no atheists in foxholes? He called out to the Lord. He said, "Lord, save me." How many times, or how many of you have done that in your life? And how many times have you cried out, "Lord, help me"? That's what we do when we're in trouble in our lives. That's what we're supposed to do when we're in trouble in our lives. It's one of my two favorite prayers. Lord, help me. The other one is, thank you, Jesus. I wonder if Peter said, thank you. And Jesus reached out and pulled him back up out of the water. But Peter got out of that boat to begin with. Peter got out of that boat to begin with because once he realized that it was Jesus and Jesus did what he said to prove him right, he said, come to me on the water. Peter's like, awesome, I can do this. I've got Jesus on my side. But when times got tough, and he started to sink, and the waves began to overwhelm him, he called out to help, called out to the Lord for help. And that's what we do in our lives. The big question is, how often do we get out of the boat to begin with? Now we look at Peter, and we can make an analogy. Because Peter is the rock upon which Christ is going to build the church. Let's make that analogy. The church is the boat. How many times from this point forward in his life did Peter step out of the boat on faith in Christ to spread the message of God to heathens and pagans and people that wanted to kill him? He did this on faith. He stepped out of the safety of the church, the boat, into the sea of chaos and confusion and evil that happens to be going on, well, in their time. And I don't know, is there any chaos or confusion or evil going on in the world today? Is our boat adrift in the sea? Are we in danger of being swamped? Are the headwinds keeping us from reaching our destination? What should we do about it? Should we do what Peter did? Should we get out of the boat? Should we step outside the confines of this church and reach out to the people in our community, to the people in our nation, and offer the love of Christ? Offer the message of God, the Word of God. I know it can be scary. It can be scary stepping out of the boat. And that makes me look back at my life, and I would invite you to do the same and see, when have I stepped out of the boat? When I was thinking about it, I thought, well, you know, I was in the boat for quite a while. I was born and raised almost literally within the Catholic Church. I actually went to a high school seminary for 2 years. I was securely in the boat. I was a solid crew member of the boat. But then I took shore leave for quite a long while. My life became a swamp of misery and alcohol. So, did I get out of the boat when I decided to sober up? No, somebody threw me a life preserver from the boat. Did I take a leap of faith and get out of the boat when I started coming to church here? No, I was getting on the boat. Now I'm on the boat. I'm a guest, right? Because I wasn't a member yet. Did I get out of the boat when I became a member of the Wesleyan United Methodist Church? No, I became part of the crew of that boat. Did I step out of the boat when I agreed to be your lay pastor a couple of years ago? No, the captain just let me hold the tiller for a while. What about when I became a licensed local pastor? No, I'm just first mate. I get to man the helm. I'm still in the boat. When have I actually stepped out of the boat? I stepped out of the boat when I started working with a ministry called Stepping Stones for You that helps recently released inmates transition back into society and spreading the word of God to them. I step out of the boat every time I offer kindness to a stranger. And when they ask me, why are you being so nice? I say, because Jesus asks me to. Because he loves me and because I need to share him with him. We do a great job from time to time of having guests come to our boat and take a little cruise around the harbor with us. But when do we step out of the boat and share the love of Christ with our neighbors? Share the love of Christ with those people who are drowning. Some of those people are calling out, Lord, help me, and we can't hear them. But if we can, will we take the time to stretch out our hand like Jesus did to Peter? Help them up and pull them into the boat with us where they are safe and where they can learn the Word of God and become a crew member on the boat and then step back out of the boat. Folks, it's been a fun sail. I love sailing in this boat. Every once in a while, it's good to step out. And if you start to sink, just do what Peter did. Cry out, Lord, help me. Amen. Our closing hymn today is, Here I Am. peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, now and forever. Let's sing God be with you.